Hello and welcome! Today we're gonna look at the CZ-75, the compact version of it made by the ASG company. So, you get a manual, the gun, a mag, a small container of BBs and an LR key for the hop-up adjustment. The manual contains the basic handling instructions, the gas you should use and other useful informations. They recommend using ultra air power gas, but you can use Protec too. It works great. Now, first thing I have to say is that it has some nice markings on it. On the left side you've got the ASG and CZ-75D compact filter on it, as well as the 0.5 joule sticker, as this one came with a green gas magazine. It can use CO2 max too. On the right side you have some small serial numbers on the front of the slide, and on the barrel you have the 9x19mm caliber marking on it, along with another type of serial number right under. The gun is made out of a nice quality plastic and the internals are all metal. It has a small weight added to it and it feels pretty balanced when you hold it in your hand. The grips seem to be rubber, actual rubber, and the touch it feels good. Being the compact version, it is of course smaller than the full size one, but you can still hold it with ease without hurting your hand or wrist. It is a non-blowback handgun, though the hammer can be cocked if you want your first shot to have a lighter pull, and be careful as it is very, very light. The trigger is good, you can feel it when it's about to snap. I think I like it more in double action. If you can see, the slide can be brought back, but that only to reveal the hop-up unit where you insert the key and adjust it. Clockwise for more, other direction for less. The sides are white dotted as most of the guns are and help you aim better. I don't know why, but personally I don't like them. I have a hard time hitting my target. Don't know if it's the gun's fault or mine, maybe it's mine. The mag is metallic with a rubberized base plate and holds 15 BBs in it. Pushing the follower down will get it fixed for you to load it. After that, you pinch this little knob and you're good to go. The system of the gun doesn't allow you to hit the pin if you don't have it inside, so the hammer would hit the plastic there is. Inserting the magazine will align everything in order to shoot. Of course, you won't shoot anything without the mag, but I thought it was worth pointing out how it works. Also, sometimes it seems that it shoots 2 BBs at once, and I don't understand why. And I don't think it's user's error here. But it still shoots straight, so that's a plus. In terms of gas efficiency, it is very efficient, I must say. You can shoot about 6 mags at the same consistency. It keeps itself up. I was pleasantly surprised by that. Anyway, you get around 90 BBs to shoot before any significant drop in power. Maybe a little bit more on a good day. What I almost forgot to mention is that it has a small ray underneath for the accessories you'd like to equip. What I found strange is the safety. It's located on the left side of the frame, so right hand friendly. You can engage it when the hammer is dropped and when it's cocked too, but it's a little bit odd. Sometimes it seems that you have to slightly pull the trigger to activate it, cause at times it feels that it will break if you push it too hard. And if you pull it when it's already engaged, it gets somehow stuck. You get some clicking noises, and it feels weird. This is a small inconvenience, at least for me, however, be careful. One last thing I can say is that it has a nice and deep groove. It helps you slide your trigger finger faster on the side when you don't intend to shoot. Don't know if this was the purpose for it, but you can use it as such. Also, you have the small cutout which can come in handy if you use gloves. And that was it for today, see you next time. Bye.